Today I'm going to show you how to make your own tilt alarm circuit using an Arduino Mega 2560 microcontroller and a tilt ball switch. What is a tilt ball switch, you ask? It's that guy right there. Welcome back to Bee Monster Laboratory. I hope you're having a fantastic 4th of July weekend. I just wanted to bring you a really quick circuit for your Arduino. One that's really fun. Let's go ahead and check it out. Now this is the tilt ball switch, and there are several different types of tilt switches. There are very ultra sensitive tilt switches, but this is a very cheap version of that, and some of them use mercury. This one uses a steel ball which is inside this cylinder. So when this is tilted and the little metal ball goes to the base of the tilt sensor, it will make a connection between these two pins, and then that'll be indicated by an alarm or the LEDs flashing on our breadboard. Now, when it goes back to horizontal, the metal ball will move away from the bottom, losing the connection between these two pins, and the flashing will stop. For this video, I used an Elegoo Mega 2560 microcontroller. I used a whole bunch of these male-to-male jumpers. I used two LEDs, mine's green and red. I used three resistors, 1, 2, 3, they're 220 ohm each. I used an active buzzer. This was in the Elegoo Mega kit, the Elegoo Mega 2560 kit. And you'll also need a tilt ball switch. This was the one that came in the Elegoo Mega kit as well. And of course you'll need a breadboard. This is a fairly small circuit, very easy to put together. You can see that I have the 5 volt coming off the board, plugged right into the rail here, the positive rail, and I have the ground wire coming off the board and plugged into the ground rail as well. Now the orange wire is my tilt pin, and it's plugged into pin 5 here on my board, and come over here and it's connected to one of the pins of my tilt switch. So one of the pins of the tilt switch is connected to the positive rail. The other pin of the tilt switch is connected to ground right here. But between that, we have a 220 ohm resistor and that orange 5-pin wire right here connected to my board. If you look at this white wire right here, it's connected to the 10 pin on my board and also to the ground pin of my green LED. And the positive pin of this green LED is connected to a 220 ohm resistor and this orange wire, which is plugged into the positive rail, which is 5 volt. This yellow cable here comes off the positive pin of the green LED and connects directly to another 220 ohm resistor, which connects to the positive pin of the red LED. The ground pin of the red LED is connected to the ground rail. I unplugged it here because it's really loud, but this is the active buzzer. And the positive pin of the active buzzer is connected to the white wire here, and that is coming out of pin 9 on my board. And then the ground pin is connected to the ground rail on my breadboard. I will also include this Tinkercad diagram so you can see the connections better. Hopefully it makes sense to you. It's my first time using it, but I do like it. I like it. I might use it again in the future. So put the tilt sensor back, and when the ball moves away from the base, the lights stop flashing, and when they move toward the base, they flash. And you can use that as an alarm or an indicator for pretty much anything. I've also included an alarm in this circuit, and I've kept it off until now so that you can hear me, but I'll plug it in and show you how it works. Well, that's all I've got for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you try this one out, let me know how it goes. If you have any comments or questions, leave them in the comment section below. And until next time, I'm Brad. Take care.